I'm here with the evergreen international master of Maharashtra, Mr. Anup Deshmukh. How was the Mumbai Mayor's Cup for you?
Start was very bad. Actually, I was playing my 8th tournament continuously. So I was very tired and I had spondylosis problems. So first 2-3 days, I was not able to play properly because same day I raced and once I caught a wrong local. Instead of going to Andheri, I went to Vashi.
Oh my god.
And after coming from there, first day it was clearly winning, I lost that game. Second day, opponent was offering regularly draw, that also I lost. And out of 3, I had only half points.
And then in the last 7 rounds, how many points did you score?
I think 6 and a half something like that.
So you scored 7 out of 10, so it was 6.5 out of 7
yeah,
in the last.
Yeah.
Wow, and the last round you beat a very strong GM. Vladimir Burmakin.
I respected him a lot. He was also 50 plus. So both of them after 3 hours, naturally we will be tired. So I was mentally prepared.
Can you take us through the game from the start?
Yeah, I started with English opening. And then...
So with the moves?
Yeah, with the moves.
I played
C4. For C4, he played naturally C5. Very strong move. Then I, instead of my normal, I played NF3, G3, BG2 type setup. And he went for knight h6, that was very rare move. G6, BG7, NH6. Very rarely played, I think. And I went cool setup, A3, rook B1, and trying to take that B4 jump. He blocked that. And all the time the zugzang was going on. Once his knight came to F5, here I made a very rare maneuvering. I didn't play D3 or E3. I just went knight E1, and then waiting for his knight to come to D4, then play E3. And for a lot of time, both were waiting. When he will jump, and finally I played E3 and C2, that type of setup. And suddenly when he played Queen E7, I had played Rook E1. So he missed my D4 jump. If he takes, my knight is coming to D5 after pawn takes, and takes D5, knight D5 is coming. So from there he started slipping up. And then his game.
I think at some point you were completely dominating the entire board.
Yeah, I was completely. Once I played F4 and his F6 was too bad. I think he was tired there. He was playing to hold the game, draw. And from there, I was like, draw is anytime in my hand. So I had calculated my bobo is so bad. I have to win only. If draw means there is no chance of coming in, finishing good. So I continued to play for win. And the finish was, I think everybody will love it. It's a very good finish.
Okay. Anup, there is one thing which everyone is interested in. We interviewed you last time. And you said you want to be one of the oldest grandmasters in the world.
I am pursuing that challenge. But I have to take care of my health first. And one tag is very difficult. When you have got that deliberate coach tag, and then it is very difficult to handle it. Now and then people will ask, will think you get some guidance only.
So in between the tournaments, you get a lot of people asking you for help.
A lot of time goes there only.
But you don't say no to anyone.
That is my weakness. And then afterward, the frustration comes. Lot of time is already wasted. We are thinking of something different. People think that at this age, what is the point in playing? Because you have already reached certain, that time it was 2-4-3-0. Now you can't cross that and all. So I'm thinking to cross that barrier.
Right, this is one of the things. Like people say that you have already crossed your prime.
I think any chess player at any age, if he has started very younger age and he have the passion, I think he can excel. I don't think there is any stopping. If you have, no doubt, you should be financially good also. Because our time, all these facilities were not there. Now, thanks to all these children and their parents are helping them a lot in a big way. So I think after 5-6 years, India will become a big boom in GM, IM and all these things.
And how do you adapt to the technology?
Actually, most of the time, I think that when this all young generation came to my house for my tips and guidance and all, whatever you call it, they only taught me how to filter. Actually, I didn't know anything. Now also, I am not perfect. Only 25% knowledge I have, whatever I got from you also, and whatever the latest boys tell me. I just play on common sense, and where it is required to calculate, I just calculate there. My weakness is only calculation.
Imagination is your strong point. How to build an attack or something like that.
Because I have seen many games from Informator. we used to sit long hours to see all the games, irrelevant of the opening and all. So we get that feel.
I know one thing which we wanted to ask you since a long time are your encounters with Vishwanathan Anand when you were young. People used to say you are actually, as talented as him.
Actually, there is no comparison because when I started, only my great mentor or coach, everything, because of that person I played chess, Dr. Prakash Rakevar. He is everything for me. Whatever he used to say, we used to do. He used to say, go to play tournament, I used to play. And then during sub-junior, I met Anand, many times we met, juniors and all. And most of the time, I don't know. It was a coincidence that many times I got very good position with Anand and managed to win also. But Anand is Anand because he had a lot of passion that time. And I was playing many games. For example, I was in school, kabaddi team, volleyball team. So we didn't know. And I took science, that was again a blunder. If we had support, I would have become a GM. I can't say I would have become like Anand and all, because I have other interests also. That was problem.
Right, so Anand was some kind of a class apart.
Yeah. When I defeated him in 83 or 82, I knew that he is going to become world champion. In one of my interview in 89, when I became youth under 25 national champion, I told Arvind Eran also that he will become world champion.
But how, even in spite of you beating him, why did you say
because
that?
Because I said his passion and that all the tears flowing from his eyes, I can make out that he is very much involved into that.
So when a kid cries, many people think it's negative, but you saw something positive.
Very positive, I saw. Because he that time told me that next time if we meet, I will crush you. He said me like this.
Oh, after the game?
After the game. And his father was standing behind us. I remember that.
That could be taken as some kind of not a good sportsman. No.
When somebody's parents are they're watching from behind, I think that is a great motivation for that who is playing against you. My parents never came in the hall throughout my life. So I think that is also a major support for this young children, because whenever your parents are there, they play more seriously and they're more engrossed.
Okay.
And when parents are not there, you play carelessly. Oh, what happens if you lose this? But when parents are regularly there, all the time that pressure is there on them. See, we have taken so much leave, we are investing. So that type of torture is there for sometimes it's good, sometimes bad.
It's not, sometimes it can go the other way also.
But out of that only, when pressure is there, then only performance comes.
Okay. That's a new kind of a way of thinking,
yeah,
because everyone thinks pressure is not good.
What I've seen is when my day, Barua's father is to come sometime, he became GM. For example, Praveen Tipse, he was alone, parents now should come, but his brothers were there to support him. So that type of support was there. You take anybody. Lanka Ravi's parents used to not come, and D.V. Prasid's parents. So they became IM only. And you take all other things. Somebody is there, mother or father, somebody is there. You take anybody.
Okay, that's a very interesting point.
I have observed all Indians. I think anybody, Lalit Babu's parent, even that Vidit's parent, Abhijit Gupta's, everything, mother, somebody is to come.
I think all these young kids are now, parents are sure to join them to ensure that they become GMs.
Very rare it is ki somebody alone taking all the way. It's very rare.
Well, thank you, Anup, for this wonderful interview, and we wish you good luck for future events.
Thanks.